Hello and welcome to this series on JMeter Beginner Tutorial. So today is the 13th session and today we are going to see how to read data from a CSV file, and it is also known as parameterization. Okay, so what we are going to look here is instead of hard coding some values into our test plan or into the request or the sampler request, we want to read the values from an external file, and we want to take the values from the file and then run our test plan. Okay, so let us see how we do that. This is a test plan that we already created in an earlier session for an API. So in case you want to know how to create this test plan, you can look into this tutorial, JMeter Beginner Tutorial 9, Testing Web Services or API. Here we have created a test plan to test SOAP as well as REST API or web services. Okay, so this is the same test plan that I am continuing with. So you can go back and look that video first and come back again in case you want to get this test plan ready on your system. So what we are going to do here is I'm going to go to thread group. Okay, and before I add in a new element, let me show you that what all we already have here is we have a REST request which is given inside an HTTP request sampler. Then the same REST request we have given into this REST RPC request sampler. Then we have a SOAP request. Okay, and if I run this, you can see this is a HTTP request which gets the weather of some particular city. So we are getting the weather of New Delhi, and in the response we are getting the information. The same API is also running here. It is also getting the weather of New Delhi and we are getting the response. And the SOAP API is for getting or listing all the cities of a country. So we are using India here, and in the response we are getting all the cities of India. Okay, now what we want to do is, instead of giving New Delhi here hard coded or this particular password, or giving India here, we want to take these values from a CSV file. Okay, so for that I will right click on my thread group and add config element CSV dataset config, and I will move it to the top. Okay, so let me write it down here as well. Step one is add config element, and the name of the config element is CSV dataset config. Okay, now here I have to give the source file name wherever my CSV file is. Okay, so let me take this file. I will name it as CSV data. Okay, let me open this. Okay, so let us see what all things we need to put. I need a city name. Okay, then I also need a API key, or you can say this is a secret or a password for this particular API. Then I also need a country name. Okay, so I will add all these parameters here. I need a city, a app ID and a country. Okay, I need these three things. Okay, so let me take city name as New Delhi and one more as Chandigarh. App ID is we have to give the same secret here. So this is a password like kind of a thing for an API. So I will give it here, and the same here. Okay, and for country let me take India and Australia. Okay, so now I have added these three variables, city, app ID and country, and I have given two set of values for all of these parameters, right? Now what I do in my JMeter is, first of all, I have to go to my CSV dataset config and give the file name. Okay, so step two will be add details in this particular config element. Okay, so the file name is, I will go here and see what is the file name. This is the location. I have to give the complete location, okay, in case I am not in the bin folder. Okay, so in case you are using Windows, you can take the location of your file. I am taking it from here. This is CSV data. Okay, so I have given the location of the file. Now in case your file is located in the JMeter bin directory, then you need not give the entire absolute path. You can directly give the name of your file like this, but in my file is located outside, so I will give the entire path. Okay, we will look at the other fields, but let me just go ahead to HTTP request, and now we have to change this, right? So step three will be update value fields. Okay, and what we have to do is, we have to give something like this. The syntax is dollar curly braces start variable name and curly braces end. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is, instead of New Delhi, now I will say dollar curly braces start and the name of my variable is city. Okay, so I will say city here and curly braces stop. Again for app ID, I will say dollar curly brace start and app ID close. Okay, I can do the same thing here as well. Instead of New Delhi, I can say this is dollar city, and in the SOAP request as well, I can say this is dollar country. Okay, now I have updated my values. Now I just need to run and validate that it is working fine. Okay, and it is taking all the values from the CSV file. Okay, now I will just execute it. HTTP request has some issue. Let me see. Okay, we need to close this as well, right? Let me close this file. Okay. Okay. So it is taking dollar city as it is. Let me see what is the issue here. We have given the name correctly. Here we have set. Okay, let me open it again and see what is the name we have given here. Oh, I think there is some issue. It got merged, right? City and app ID. Oh, it got merged into a single column. I don't know how it happened, but let me just fix this. App ID should be column number 2, and this is the value of app ID. Cut it from here, paste it here. And country is column number 3. Okay. This is India will come here. and here it will be Australia. This will be same. And then let me remove this from here. Okay, so now we have city New Delhi and Chandigarh, app ID and country Indian Australia. Let me close it and test it again. Okay. And yes, I think this time it took it correctly. Let us also verify. See, it has taken city as New Delhi and the app ID. Same thing here, city as New Delhi and the app ID. And it has given us a correct response as well. It has given us the weather of New Delhi. And in the SOAP request, it has taken country as India and given the response as all the cities of India. Okay. Now, see, we had two values, right? Two records into our CSV file, right? So we had two records, but it took only the first record, right? Why? Let us see why it took only the first record, because we have given only single iteration, right? So let me increase the iteration by 2, and now let us see, start it again. So the first iteration is done, and now the second iteration, right? So see, the first iteration it took New Delhi, second iteration it took Chandigarh. Okay, similarly for SOAP, the first iteration it took India and the second iteration it took Australia. Okay, and gave us the response as well, right? So this is how we can take data from an external file. Now let us also understand quickly what the other fields means. So variable names, suppose I give the variable names that I used there, city, app ID and country. I can give it here as well, but in that case what will happen is it will consider the first row as well as values. Okay, so what it will do is it will consider the first row also as values, and in the first iteration it will give city as the city name, app ID as the app ID, and country as the country. But we do not want that. That is why we have not given it here. Okay. So delimiter, by default it is comma. You can use backslash t for tab if you want. Allow quoted data. If you have quoted data in your CSV file, you can make it as true, else false, or you can also edit and give some custom value as well, right? Recycle on EOF, what this means is recycle on end of file. This means is that if you have two rows in your CSV, but if you set the loop count as 3, then the first loop count will take the first row, the second loop count will take the second row, and then the third loop count will again go to the first row in case you have set it as true. In case you have set it as false, then it will not go, right? Again, stop thread on end of file. If you set it as true, what will happen is as soon as the data will complete in your CSV file, or it will reach end of file, it will stop the thread. And if you set it as false, it will not. Okay. Sharing mode, what does this mean is, see, by default, whenever you create a CSV dataset config, it is by default shared with all the threads in your test plan. So suppose you create some more test plans or some more thread groups into this test plan, this particular dataset will be shared within all the thread groups. But if you want that every thread group should have its own data set or CSV file and it should not be shared, then you can set it as current thread only. So now this particular CSV will only be valid for this particular thread group, and if you create new threads, it will not be valid for those. Okay, so this is what all this means. So this is how we can create CSV file and we can use the data in CSV file to run our test plan. I hope you like it. Happy learning. Thank you.